to also play to win instead of playing not to lose. That was very, very important to us.
The Wildcats, in the face of terrific Georgetown pressure, immediately seek to establish an inside game. Harold Presley makes it 2-0 Villanova. But the Hoyas four leader, Michael Jackson, finds David Wingate, who quickly ties the score at 2. Dwayne McLean shows there's no fear in these Wildcats. A Villanova turnover gives the ball back to the Hoyas, and Ewing lets fly from long range. Bill Martin is there for the rebound, and Georgetown leads by 4. But during the first 6 minutes of the game, Villanova is perfect from the field. Dwayne McLean hits his 3rd straight to close the gap. Villanova finally misses, and the Hoyas take advantage with a gorgeous fast break from Martin to Jackson to Wingate. The Hoyas threaten to break it open using Ewing inside and Reggie Williams outside. Much to the displeasure of Rolly Massimino, Georgetown takes a 6-point lead. With the Hoyas on the verge of pulling away, the Wildcats show their poise, slowing the tempo and working the ball for a good shot. Georgetown comes up empty twice in a row, and Dwayne McLean takes charge. He goes over the outstretched Ewing for his 4th basket without a miss. Villanova is shooting 90%, Georgetown 67, and the game is tied at 20. For the next 60 seconds, the two teams go at each other like a couple of heavyweights. First Ewing, then Presley drives, and gets the bounce. Ewing counters with an exclamation point. Gary McLean bombs away over Ewing. Ewing isn't finished. The fearless Wildcats match the mighty Hoyas basket for basket. Harold Jensen cuts Georgetown's lead to 1. Late in the half, with Pinckney on the bench with 2 fouls, Villanova again slows down the pace. This second effort by Presley gives Villanova a 1-point halftime lead. Villanova's phenomenal shooting continues. Gary McLean gives the Wildcats a 6-point lead after 3 minutes of the second half, and Villanova fans start thinking national championship. But steady Bill Martin has other ideas, and he puts Georgetown fans back on their feet. Villanova tests the Hoyas inside. This flip by Dwayne McLean and the ensuing foul shot give his team a 5-point lead with 13 minutes left. Hoya fans have come to expect great things from Patrick Ewing, and once again he responds. But Villanova's defense tonight is supernatural. Ewing will manage just one more field goal in his last 13 minutes. Meanwhile, the shooting remains red hot, and the lead changes hands 6 times in the next 3 minutes. Harold Jensen averaged just 4 points per game during the season, but he shows he's not afraid to pull the trigger. He gets the roll, and Villanova sustains its amazing shooting percentage at 77. The lead continues to seesaw. This driving layup by Wingate gives the Hoyas a one-point lead, but it doesn't last long. The Wildcats capitalize on two Georgetown misses and look to Ed Pinckney, who gets another good roll to forge a five-point lead. But the Hoyas are the defending champions, and they won't go down easily. Six unanswered points, aided by three Villanova turnovers, put Georgetown back on top. Ahead by 1 point with less than 4 minutes remaining, the Hoyas revert to their vaunted four corners offense. But perhaps the game's most crucial turnover gives possession back to the Wildcats. After calling timeout for a last-minute strategy talk, Villanova spreads the offense. Jensen finds an opening, and Villanova takes the lead 55-54 with 2.5 minutes to go. Jensen has hit all five of his shots from the field, and Villanova has missed just one shot in the second half. The Hoyas look for a good shot, but Wingate can't find the range. As the clock winds down inside of 2 minutes, Villanova works the ball around patiently, and the Hoyas are forced to foul. The Wildcats' newest hero, Jensen, hits four consecutive foul shots, giving him 14 points and his team a five-point lead. Just under 1 minute remaining. Ewing tries to close the gap, but Dwayne McLean grabs the precious rebound, and the Hoyas are forced to foul again. Georgetown prays for a miss. And their prayers are answered. Villanova's lead remains at five as the Hoyas rush down court. But the Hoyas give the ball right back, and Villanova heads to the foul line with 52 seconds left to play. Harold Jensen concentrates, but the roll is not there, and the desperate Hoyas set up once again. To within three, but time is running out. Villanova again plays keep away, forcing another Georgetown foul, and a delirious crowd roars its approval. This time McLean doesn't miss. Four straight clutch free throws in the closing seconds give him a game-high 17 points and put the finishing touches on one of the great upsets in NCAA tournament history. Villanova winds up shooting a tournament record 79% from the field. The Wildcats needed a perfect game to beat the Hoyas, and they got it. And just imagine the feelings of this man, Jake Nevin, team trainer since 1929, to whom the Villanova players had dedicated their entire season. To Rolly Massimino, it was a dream come true.
Winning the NCAA championship is probably the finest thing that's ever happened to me since having a wife and a family and a mother and a father. Getting to the Final Four was the culmination for me. Winning the championship was a miracle.
If ever a team seemed destined to repeat, to do what nobody had done since UCLA back in 73, it was the 1985 Georgetown team. But as one fella said to me on the floor of Rep Arena just a couple of minutes after the buzzer, just another Monday night in the Big East.